Today I decided to talk a bit about my favorite card game, and pretty much the only card game I play outside of like two games of Pokemon, Magic the Gathering. So, I'm gonna assume that if you're watching this video, you already know how to play Magic the Gathering, but I might as well give a freshener, cause, well, maybe you don't know the terms. So, what I'm gonna talk about today is the absolute fucking state of Limited's monopoly on Magic the Gathering's set design. So, this might sound a bit wordy, and to be fair, honestly, it is. But, basically, what I mean is, what I try to say is that Magic the Gathering has these game modes, which are called limited game modes, where basically you get handed a bunch of boosters and get told to open them and try and make something playable out of it. It can be quite fun, and it's quite a challenge to try and make a deck out of the hands you're dealt. And you know, it's overall pretty fun. The community is quite large and enthusiastic about limited. So what's the problem? Well, you see, the problem with limited is that it is fucking ruining a lot of the Magic the Gathering set design. Now you see, back in the olden days, back before, you know, Limited really took off as an official supported thing, you know, PPTQs and Top 8s didn't always have runs of draft with runs of constructed. Back in the day, it was just constructed. Now, I'm not gonna say that just constructed is better than that, because honestly I think seeing drafts in a competitive environment can be quite interesting. Also, it helps with, let's say, you're a bit more disenfranchised. Even if training is going to be a bit harder, doing a booster draft is going to be a lot cheaper to do at a top 8 than coming in with some $600 scred deck or whatever. So that's a pretty good advantage, right? Right. But there's other problems with it too. One of them being, which is sort of the crux of this, a lot of recent sets have been fucking really bad in a lot of places because they are sort of focusing a bit too much on limited, in my opinion. Now, of course, the best thing to compare it with would be Master Set. These are sets that aren't standard legal and contain only reprints of cards generally played in other formats, or just generally having some kind of fame attached to them, or sometimes infamy, but that's another thing. However, recently, especially with, well, they kind of always been like that, but mainly recently, a lot of the Master Set have been focused on, quote-unquote, making the best drafting experience possible. And that may be true, I can't fucking say, because here's the problem. Master Set, for some reason, are $10 more. Now you might say, oh, it's because there's more expensive cards in it. First off, Wizard of the Coast aren't supposed to say that the secondary market exists. These cards cost the same fucking print as normal-ass standard cards, so it shouldn't cost more. First off, that's a fucking weird quandary, wouldn't you think? Now, obviously, the reason is that it makes them more money, because people are gonna chase after that one rare mythic that's worth $500 fucking dollars by itself. I mean, that's completely fair, they are completely in the right to do so, but doesn't make it not fucking bullshit, that's for damn sure. But even then, you know, that's, you're gonna tell me, but Mick, these sets are filled with so many cool cards, obviously they're gonna be worth more, and you would be right. Except you're wrong. Because the problem here is, a lot of the cards in Master Set are complete trash. A lot of the commons and uncommons and even a couple of rares are $25 to $1 cards. They did not need a reprint. And these sets are about reprinting cards in order to put them into a player's hands. It doesn't matter if drafting iconic masters is awesome. If I gotta pay $50 instead of $20 to attend the draft, I'm not gonna do it. I'm just gonna pick up like fucking 3 booster packs for $150 at the dollar store and run that instead, just to wash the taste of having to paying $50 to draft cards, most of which are gonna be fucking useless. And yeah, a lot of drafters have so much common chaff that they just leave it on the ground. It's not even worth picking it up and putting it in boxes. It's that useless. And the same is true for the Master Sets, which are supposed to be filled with awesome cards that are worth a lot. Now you're gonna tell me, well, they're gonna fill the common slot at one point, and there's not enough commons to be reprinted for this to effectively work. And yeah, that's entirely fair. But even then, the thing with master sets, apparently, is that they just really didn't think it through when they started making these things, because the first, the modern masters and such, made them a buttload of fucking money with Tarmogoyfs and all those cool cards. The thing is, if they fill the set with nothing but chase cards, well, they're gonna run out of them quick. And they just couldn't really continue with that, so they had to fill them with more and more garbage to basically just extend the time before they're gonna run out. But the thing is, even with this explanation, who the hell needed a reprint of Bog Brew Witch? Who the hell needed a reprint of Dragon Hatchling? Nobody. Nobody needs a reprint of an already worthless card. Now sure, it might be fun, it might be cool, but if you're gonna put it in because it's a cool card, not just because it would make for a good draft environment, because nobody draft master sets, they're too expensive to do so. You gotta be fucking filthy stinking rich to be able to draft these damn things. And sure, you might fill it with as many archetypes as you want, but those archetypes are taking place of cards that could actually be seen play somewhere. Shit, the fact that it still costs 600 goddamn dollars to make a modern deck, that's as if you're playing cheap, kinda shows that they aren't running out of shit to reprint. And even then, just the simple concept of the master set kind of invalidates the point that the Wizard of the Coast is not supposed to acquiesce the existence of the secondary market, much less what's expensive and what's not. So this whole thing is already a logistical problem on itself, and goddamn, it's a nightmare. But even then, standard sets, and you know, sets before standard, also have this problem as well. Although obviously they're a bit more grimy because they don't make as clear as this, an example as this, as Master Set. Because Master Set are openly told to be drafted, while Standard Set obviously aren't. You could say they're made for constructed, but recently they haven't fucking been at all. Like, I'm supposed to be extremely angry right now, but honestly, just talking about this makes me more sad than anything. It's a fucking sad state. The power creep is going up at a rate that is frankly insane compared to the rest of Magic's history. Like, sure, there's always been a bit of a power creep. Imagine the fact that back then, Grizzly Bears, a 2-2 for 2 with nothing else, was seen as really good. Nowadays, they can't even print a 2-2 for 2 vanilla creature anymore, because it would be too much garbage. 2-2s for 2, now I have upsides. And now you're getting 4 mana creatures that also have Slay, so it costs less than if you played a 2-2 for 2 and Slay and Murder, which costs 3. And I mean, that fucking Chupacabra was a perfect example. A shit ton of pros went ahead ripping Wizard of the Coast's a new asshole, talking about how much this card was just power creep in and of itself. It may not seem that much, but the value on this thing is way too intense. Creatures nowadays are too fucking intense. There's nothing but value. The second you slam this thing on the floor, it gets you value. It's way too, the creatures are way too safe, and the instant and sorceries are almost always worse than previous versions. Like, that's not even thinking about Lightning Bolt and comparing it with Shock. Shock is fine. It would be a good card if Lightning Bolt did not exist, and that's entirely fair. But then you look at motherfucking Open Fire. Oh yeah, 3 mana, deal 3 damage, target creature play. The only thing that they could have done to make it worse was if it was a sorcery. We've now reached a point where sorceries and instant have drawbacks, while creatures have all the fucking bonuses. It's gone completely lopsided, and sure, I'm not saying that one is better than the other, but their reasoning has first off never been really clear, and second off, never really made much sense. Like, in theory, to make a good game, you would probably want spells that are just as good as creatures. But back in the day, spells were way better than creatures. But nowadays, creatures are way fucking better than spells. Apparently, the reasoning for that is because a board filled with creatures and permanents is more exciting and faster to look at being played on, like, Twitch and stuff. Like, they're really thinking about the public image of what Magic looks like on the scene, and I think that's not really healthy for the gameplay of it. Like, sure, playing big, stompy, Temmy creatures or insta-value fucking dogs. Like, sure, I guess, it's called Magic the Gathering, and you are playing a spell, which you certainly aren't casting instant and sorceries much. And you might say, oh, but red deck wins still in standard and blah blah blah, and sure, you're right. How many of them play fucking Open Fire? Have you looked at how many sorceries there are? Especially Ixalan and Rivals of Ixalan has this criminal lack of instants. Everything is almost a fucking sorcery. And some have said this is because they don't want Magic the Gathering Arena to get too complex by filling it with instants. Gotta say, sounds like a fucking bad idea in my opinion, but eh, I'm just saying. Hell, a lot of the time, this is just not amazing. Look at the fucking sad state that we're in. Hell, I think the best example I can give is Carnage Tyrant versus Colossal Dreadmaw. Carnage Tyrant is a mythic rare 6 mana 7/6 with hexproof that cannot be countered. Colossal Dreadmaw is a 6 mana 6/6 with trample. Common. Now, unless I am clinically retarded, I am certain that 100% of the time, Carnage Tyrant is better than Colossal Dreadmaw. All the fucking time. There is no reason to run Colossal... There is no fucking reason to run Colossal Dreadmaw. Colossal Dreadmaw will be played in a draft, and after that, will be used to fucking tampon off. Colossal Dreadmaw will be played in a draft and then used as a way to plug your pipes by jamming it inside of the fucking plumbing. This card is so useless and so worthless, I'd use it to pick my teeth before casting it on the battlefield. The only reason Colossal Dreadmaw exists is because of draft. And even then, they were so goddamn lazy, it's even obvious. They're both in the same set, the same creature type, they're so easy to compare. It's like somebody at Wizards wanted us to notice that Standard was going in a horribly weird and desperate situation and just did this as some sort of in-house satire. That's the only explanation I have for such absolute stupidity of a caliber the likes of which I have... Alright, I've seen stupider things, but in Magic, I don't think I have. Like, sure, Standard is in a better place than Combo Winter, but even then, that's kind of debatable considering the amount of bannings there have been. Clearly, they forgot how to design cards. And now I'm certain, I'm actually very optimistic about Dominaria. They're starting their new play design theme, which I think should be good. They brought back Richard Garfield, PhD, praise be his name, into the fucking game. He's not a saint, but at least he knows how to fucking cast spells and have fun. And I'd be so goddamn serious all the time, but this isn't a fucking Magic Health podcast or whatever. It's a video about Limited being a cancer to set design. And you might say, hell, Mythic Rares are nothing but there for basically blocking off some cards from Limited. Like, it's even said many times by Wizard of the Coast top designers that the reason for Mythic Rares and Rares is just to put the cards that they don't want to see in Limited much. And overall, I can't just... I'm just not a fan of this direction. Like, I think this whole thing I've been blabbering on about is mostly subjective, but I just really like the game. And none of what I'm seeing seems good. So many examples I can pull off of shit being bad. And fuck, I'm just gonna talk about Open Fire again, because I need to get angry, not sad. That's what gets the fucking YouTube money. Fucking Open Fire! Holy shit! That card is horrible. Holy crap, I never saw a card this horrible in all of my Magic the Gathering life. Like, you might say, oh, Chains of Mephistopheles, oh, Catacombs, oh, Bliettes, no, fuck off. Open Fire. You can go burn in literal fire. This card, 3 mana, deal 3 damage. I talked about it before, but holy shit, I'm gonna talk about it again. Holy crap. Can you ask me? Now you might say, well, Open Fire isn't trash and limited. Yeah, you're right. Except for the fact that fucking Shock would also be better in limited. Hell, Shock or Lightning Strike or anything with actual fucking value. Hell, Lightning Strike should not be an uncommon. It should not. 3 mana, deal 3 damage. That is just horrible. I would rather have a fucking 1 red X deal X damage. At least that can scale. That can be used to win a game if you're mana flooding. But fucking Open Fire? Let me tell you, there is no deck ever that will ever run Open Fire outside of limited decks. It's a card invented only for limited decks because they printed Shock in the set before and didn't want it to print it again. But the worst thing is, they could have done something cool with it. What about 3 mana, deal 3 damage, but it also has another effect. It has an upside, like the bear I talked about. See, it all goes back. How come creatures can get 2/2s for 2s with upsides, but apparently spells can't? You cannot get a 3 mana deal 3 damage with an upside at common. That's crazy talk. That would give players something good and fun. Something they can think about. Something that doesn't make them tap out just to do 3 damage to creature or player. Because, oh no, it's sad. Because I bolted Timmy's giant dinosaur. Fuck off. It's the same reason that land destruction is now nearly gone. Back in the day, 3 mana was the cost to destroy a land. I can understand some people aren't happy with getting their lands destroyed. It's kind of an important thing that you need to have unless you're playing Dredge. But I feel like land destruction has a place as a viable, real, and playable deck. And sure, it's bad to play against, but in theory, you could have answers to it. If you're playing ramp, then technically you should be able to ramp up faster. If you're playing combo, well, yeah, you're gonna get hosed, but if you're playing control, you can counter all of his land destruction. You got ideas, and it feels like they really don't want to challenge the players with just challenges, really, just things to try, ideas to mix, decks to brew. I mean, it might just be because Ixalan and Rivals are heavily tribal focused, and as such, the decks are kind of built for you. But you could say that about every mechanic, honestly. Like, even then, like, they almost did this with things like Enrage, I think is actually a very good mechanic that honestly got better with Rivals. Like, in Ixalan, I didn't see the thing. But in Rivals, I saw the idea. But it just feels like they want to go creature heavy and not give anything else to instant and sorceries. They ban a card that's apparently too good just because it allows you to be better with instant and sorceries. I just find it sad. Like, shit, they even banned Ramunap Ruins. Oh yeah, 4 mana, sacrifice a land, deal 2 damage to a creature or player? Christ. Honestly, I wouldn't be surprised if in a year or two we'll see Lightning Bolt cost 4 mana. You know, maybe even even 5, or maybe it would cost 3 mana, but it's 3 fucking red symbols instead of being 2 colorless. Hopefully their whole play design thing works. I'm hoping for the best anyway. That's only the best thing. Only the best way to see it. I'm not gonna be here just being angry all the time. I still love the game. And I only want it to succeed. Just so far, it doesn't look like they're on the path to staying the game that I like to play. Just stuff to talk about. Anyway, that was Mickey O's ramble of the, well, same month, year. It's ramble of the moment. I wanted to yell. I yelled. And now I feel better. Hopefully you fell asleep while I was yelling. Honestly, that's kind of the goal of the videos. Good night.